Behind every model there's a story, which we share here on YouTube. And if you're interested in following our story, then please subscribe and hit the notification bell. Okay, so let's see if this solution works, or are we gonna be melting and bending and breaking axles again? Last time we were driving this model, we found an issue, which was with the rear differential. It seems like the axle melted, or the whole brick melted. Yeah, it's stuck in there. So basically, the problem was that the power of the BuWizz motors made this frame, the gear, the axle, everything to melt. So what I changed was that I used a half-studded beam here to put the gear as close to the gear to the differential as possible, and I also lubricated the whole thing. So now the gear is much closer to differential, so there should be much less side force on it, much less bending force, and the whole thing is lubricated. And we will test it out to see how well it works. Another issue was with the ground clearance, but unfortunately I couldn't find any good solutions to fix that, because the model is simply just so low and so bendy that there is no good solution I managed to find. But we will test it here. We'll be driving it around. Okay, let's start slowly and then see if everything works. And full power. So far, so good. Oh, we lost something. Oh, so what happened? So the model is still too low because yeah, we didn't change anything regards to that, and I think we just hit a edge here somewhere, and yeah, we lost a bit of the underside. Okay, let's see the gears. Are we having any problems? So far, so good. Stress testing showed that the rear wheel drive differential solution seems to be working really good. There was no skipping gears, there are no signs of any axle melting, and we really pushed the car hard. So we were accelerating hard, braking, reversing. We even tried blocking the cars and spinning the wheels, and the gearbox, the driveline seems to be working really good. So there is no visible sign of damage here. So as far as the drive, the gearbox, the gears, it works perfectly now. But the other problem is, and that will always be, the ground clearance. We just picked up so many leaves and so many things, and all the bricks down here are so scratched up. So I tried my best to increase the ground clearance, but the model is just, it's just too flexible, and it bends in the center. So as far as making instructions for this model, I think we're gonna skip it, because this is simply not to our standards. It's simply, the car is simply too weak mechanically, or should I say structurally, and I would not be happy releasing instructions for something so flimsy. They're just simply not up to my standards. So it was a good experiment. We learned a lot. But yeah, it's still not good enough in my book.